Good day, fellow Pototanons. It's September 3, and today is the 18th year anniversary of our late great mayor, Mayor Manuel Quedó Parcon. Manuel Quedó Parcon, or Quedó for short, was our longtime mayor. Madugay siya nga naging mayor sang aton nga banwa. And over the years, he developed some kind of legendary status among the people, not only of Pototan, not only of Iloilo, but perhaps the whole country. Quedó Parcon is well remembered, and people liken him to a godfather. Godfather because kadamo siya sang ginmaninuyan ng mga tao, maninoy sa kasal, maninoy sa bunyag, maninoy sa konfirma. So he was indeed literally a godfather, kagdamo siya sang may nabuligan. He helped so many people that he literally changed many people's lives. So now we celebrate and remember the man, the legend himself, Manuel Quedó Parcon, the late great mayor and congressman of the 3rd District and mayor of Pototan. So who is exactly Manuel Quedó Parcon? Well, to many sa kadamaan, Quedó was such a legendary figure. He was larger than life, and truly, we can consider him larger than life because he did many great things, not only for Pototan, but he did things that affect the whole province of Iloilo and perhaps the direction and the political direction of the whole country. So, Manuel Quedó Parcon was born in December 1, 1934. And to us, his family, we just call him Tito Kid. Tito Kid was the first cousin of our papa, Dr. Andres Cuanco. His mother, Quedó's mother, Lola Julit, and our grandmother, Lola Unti, were sisters. So, Dr. Guanco and Mayor Parcon were first cousins. And they were together in public service for a very long time. So, let's get to know Quedó. Well, Quedó Parcon started out as a one-term councilor here in the 1960s. And in 1964, he was elected mayor of Pototan. And from then on, he built his reputation, not only here in Pototan, but in neighboring towns and in the whole of the province. Pototan back then, before he was mayor, was known by many things. Pototan was known as a rough place of criminals, place where you can't be safe. At isang una, sa nabatian naton sa aton ng mga katigulangan, uso sang una ang panakaway sang karbaw, uso ang pangati, ang pagsaka sa mga panimalay, kag kung sa modern parlance, it's pang hold up, no? Sakaan ka sa balay mo, kag hold up kon ka, kag kwaon ang imo nga mga pagkabutang, ang imo nga kwarta. So damo sang mga gangs nga nag-operate sa dito diri sa aton sa banwa sang Pototan. Well, all that changed when Manuel Quedó Parcon became mayor of Pototan. First and foremost, he instituted a policy of peace and order. where he patrolled the whole municipality, the whole town every night. Nabantugan si Quedó na wala siya nagatulog kung gabi. Kayman, kung gabi dira, aktibo ang mga kriminal, ang mga lain ng mga elemento sa susyudad. So, kaupod niya ang mga pamatanon sa Pototan, kagang kaupod man ang mga kapulisan, ginarunda yagid ang bilog gabanwa sa Pototan. Ginaisa-isa yagid ang mga kabaranggayan, kapatrolya, sadto nga tiyempo, wala pa sing mga kalsada sa mga kabaranggayanan, sa mga kabaryuhan. So, sadto nga tiyempo, daw jeep pa lang tong iyang salakyan, di uso nga jeep, no? Off-roader. Kaga kung hindi na masulod sang salakyan, they go on foot. Kagina kakadto siya sa mga panimalay, kaga nagapamangkot sang sitwasyon. And may mga istorya sang una gani nga kung madula gani ang imong karbaw sang una, tinidto mo na makita siya sa hilikon. So, kung magrunda si Quedó kung gabi, kag makasaka siya abi sa mga panimalay, nga nadulaan sang karbaw, mapanumbungon ina siya ang mga tagbalay, kag sigurado nga pagkabuwas na adlaw, ara na ang inyong karbaw nakakalat na sa dalon, sa guwasan inyong balay. So, that's how that's how Quedó is concentrated and dedicated to solving the peace and order situation here in Pototan. So, through that actions, he built a reputation for himself, and over time, his reputation preceded him. And wherever he goes, his reputation precedes him. Wala pa siya gani kaabot. Ara nang iyang reputasyon na siya isa ka maisog na tao, siya isa ka disiplinaryong klase ka tao, kag ginakadlokan siya sang mga kriminal, ginakadlokan siya sang mga malain na mga elementos diri sa aton na sosyedad. So from there on, nakahimo siya sang iyang base, and people from all over are going to him asking for help, asking for favors, and he promptly gave help to people. He is a friend to the lowly, to the destitute, to the lower margins of society, because he always gives help when help is needed. And so, people, amat-amat nga naga request si iya nga mangin maninoy nila. So that's where nga he became the godfather of Pototan, literally, because, well, if you are a godfather, you have a moral and spiritual obligation to support that man whenever he is in trouble. So amuna siya si Quedó, nangin maninoy siyang tanan, he became the godfather, and he helped so many people in his many years of service. So over the years, there are legends that grew around Quedó. He holds office, no, sa iyang balay, sa idalom sang paho. So amuna siya na nabantugan man ng iyang balay, where he resides and where he dispense his jurisdiction and his favors and justice to everybody. He all did it under the mango tree. So amo na siya ang ginhalinan na maghambal ka sa poder ni Quedó, ara ka sa poder sa idalom sang paho, o kon ang lugar nga ina gin nabantugan na dalumpaho. So aside from that, no, may ara pa gid nga mga leyenda, so kon legends nga nag to how no palibot sa iya. May mga ara na istorya nga si Quedó pagbunag sa iya, may ara siya nga kapid nga manog. Kami mismo nga mga kabataan nagapati gid sini sa una nga si Tito Kid may ara gid siya kapid nga manog. So amoy ni siyang legend pagid nga nakapahimo sang mystic palibot sa iya. May ara siya kay iya kaugalingon nga aura nga nag-emanate halin sa iya. Gapadulong pa lang siya makita na siya mabatsyagan ang iyang aura. Kagdugangan pagid nga ang iya nga mga hinuptanan nga mga kasapatan hindi man ordinaryo nga mga hinuptanan. Sa una may ara siya sang agila kag ang pinagid niya ka famous niya nga pet is his pet crocodile which is still alive until today. Ara pa na gyapon dira sa atubang sang ilang balay. So tigulang na ina nga crocodile or nga buaya and kung gusto niyo magtan-aw ara pa na siya da gihapon. So amo na siya may mga mystic and legends that surround Quedó. And dugangan pagid sang butang nga Manuel Quedó Parcon wala siya nagkakaon sang ahos. So ano bala ang ginapatihan sa mga tao nga ang manog kunon hadlok sa ahos. So si Quedó hindi kauyon sang ahos ara pagid nabantugan pagid nga aha matuod gid man nga may kapid nga manog si Quedó Parcon. So amoy na siya ang mga legends no nga nagasurround kay Quedó and throughout his many years as mayor may mga istorya nga kung ikaw nakahimo sang sala isaya lang ka katampuyong lipong ka hakwaton niya lang ka sa isaya kakamot kag ihaboy sa likod sang iya nga pick up kag pagadalon nga pagapresuhon dalaya ikaw. So he also has an aura of strength no nga daw ka powerful sa iya kag makusog din siya na klase ka tao. Sang kadapali lang ka, sang katampuyong ka, malipong ka. And during that time, ginistorya sa mga aton mga katigulangan, kung may makita siya nga daw subtil na gidkayo ng mga tao, iya iniginadakop kag ginagapos sa flagpole sang munisipyo. Well, daw subong daw hindi na ina-acceptable ng mga klase sa mga pagdisiplina. But let us all understand that during that time, that was a normal form of discipline. And siyempre kung makatilaw ng tao sa silot, hindi gid na sila magliwat pa sa ila ng mga katuntuhan. And then may ara pagid ng mga bagay nga kang ulihi ang mga malain nga elemento diri sa Pototan, mga kriminal, they dare not to commit their crimes in Quedó's turf. Pang hold up sila, panghimo sang pangkidnap sila, pero hindi gid sila maghimo sang ila ng mga krimen diri sa sulod sang banwa sa Pototan. So that's how Quedó shape Pototan. And because of him, peace and order nagkari sa atong na banwa. And because of peace and order damo na ng mga investors and businesses came to Pototan. And that is why Pototan prospered under him because he created such an ideal climate for investment because of the good peace and order situation here in Pototan. So he developed the infrastructure here in Pototan, ang Pototan na daan was well planned pa lang sa tiyempo ni Mayor Perez, Florentino Perez. Well planned ang atong na plaza, and during the later parts of his term ginpahimo iya kaging pagwapo ang atong na plaza. That's how we got our plaza today. He improved it and he made barangay roads all over the barangay, which made all the barangays accessible. Wala sing barangay na hindi masudlan sang salakyan diri sa Banwasang Pototan. And that is because of the efforts of Manuel Quedó Parcon. So, kagdiri sa Banwa, sa poblasyon, wala sing kalye nga wala na simento. So, that's all of the things he made for Pototan. And because of this, no, nanging famous siya, and because of his fame and his reputation, isang ulihi ang mga dalagko ng mga politiko nagapalapit sa iya, halin sa mga presidente, senador, congressman, mayors, nagakadto sa iya kag magpamangkot, kag mangayo sang iya abiso kung paano magpadalagan sang ilang mga banwa sing maayo. Kada tiyempo sang eleksyon, tanan nga kandidato halin sa nasyonal, tanan nga mga kandidato halin sa tanan nga nga partidos nga kadto sa iya, kag nagapangayo sang iya bendisyon, kag sang iya nga bulig, kag agud nga ma-endorso siya ni Quedó Parcon. Because kung may ara ka endorsement ni Quedó Parcon, sigurado nga magadaog ka diri sa probinsya sang Iloilo. And because of that, a lot of policies and a lot of decisions affecting the whole province of Iloilo were made under the mango tree sa iyang balay. So that mango tree is very historic for the province of Iloilo. Congressmen, senators, and even presidents came to that mango tree and seek the wise counsel of Quedó Parcon and seek also his endorsement during election times. So, tama na gid kasikat si Quedó Parcon, and amuna siya na he is well known all over the Philippines. May ara pa gani ng mga istorya, halin ang mga unayang mga imahe is he was a warlord, kay iti maisog siya kang ulihi nangin maayong na is like a benevolent father to the town, and he became the grand old man of Iloilo politics. So in his later years, in 1997, together with us, with a group of private individuals, he conceptualized the Iwag Christmas Festival of Lights, which made Pototan the Christmas capital of Western Visayas. So kung ano kasikat subong ang Pototan bilang Christmas capital sa bilog na Pilipinas, tungod ina sa kay aton na anay Mayor Manuel Quedó Parcon. After many years of service, in 1987, during the time of the People Power Revolution, all incumbent officials were changed into OIC officials. And that was the time when Quedó Parcon, for the first time in long many years, stepped down from office. Kag madumduman ko, may mga tao gani nga naga vigil nga nasubuan gid sa tubang sa iyang balay nga magapanaog na siya bilang isa ka mayor sa Pototan. But he can't do anything because the national government has changed he has to step down as mayor of Pototan. But after a few years, when elections were resumed, he again ran for mayor of Pototan, and he promptly won again as mayor of Pototan, and served again for many long years as the mayor. And during the last years, of his first 3-year term as mayor after the 1987 EDSA revolution, he became congressman of the 3rd district of Iloilo. He served in Congress, but he himself said that he is not made for legislative work. He wants action. He wants to be with the people. He wants to be in the ground. He wants to be in the field. So after one term as congressman of 3rd district, he again returned as mayor of Pototan. And after he became mayor of Pototan again, for a short time, he became mayor. Wala yan natapos ang iyong term, masakit siya, and he died in September 3, 2002. And a lot of people were saddened and shocked when he was when he died in 2002. I remember we were at St. Paul's Hospital back then, and when his body was brought from the city to Pototan, there was a lot of cars who joined the cortege from the city to Pototan. And he was laid to rest. First, he was laid in state in the local government center, which he built as an office for himself. And as his coffin was carried in the shoulders of uniformed policemen going to their house, we remember a flock of birds suddenly came and swarmed all over the plaza of Pototan. And many people noticed that, and they said, maybe that was the spirit of Quedó Parcon. It was so real. It was kapalanindog ang imong abalahibo. Makita mo ito. And then he was buried, and perhaps when he was buried, it was the longest funeral march in the history of Pototan. More than 10,000 people came for his funeral and lined the streets from their house to the church, and from the church to the municipal cemetery. He was given full military honors, as befitting him as a reserve soldier of the armed forces of the Philippines. And there were helicopters flying, dropping flower petals all over the town. And all the people are overcome with grief as we laid Quedó Parcon to rest for the final time in the municipal cemetery of Pototan. Well, from then on, Vice Mayor Ito Perez succeeded him as mayor, and his legacy continued. Sa atong pagtakop, I had a post in Facebook like years ago about Quedó Parcon, which I would like to read to you today in honor of his death anniversary. September 3 marks the day when a great man went to his eternal reward. We honor the man and the legend. Manuel Peña Florida Parcon, known to many as Quedó, longtime mayor of Pototan, as well as congressman of the 3rd District of Iloilo. He is the father of modern Pototan. It was all because of him that Pototan is what it is today. Known as the Godfather to ordinary folks, he held office under the mango tree from where he dispensed favors and justice. To the needy, he was always there to lend a helping hand. And he is said to have a snake for a twin brother and had a crocodile for a pet. His reputation precedes him, and he was the terror of wrongdoers. Criminals dared not to commit any crime in his turf. He kept the peace, and Pototan prospered under him. He was the kingpin and the kingmaker of Iloilo politics. Officials from presidents to vice presidents to senators down to congressmen and mayors came to see him, to seek his wise counsel and his endorsement during election times. From this, he brought vast development to the municipality. He was the greatest mayor we ever had, and it will be a long time before we can have someone else as great as him. Loved by the lowly, feared by people of villainy, and respected by the mighty, it was him, the great Quedó Parcon. But to us, his family, he was just our Tito Kid, who would tell stories of his past exploits during family gatherings. I was privileged to have served under him in the municipal council when I was an SK president and later a councilor. And I am grateful for what I have learned from him. To us, the next generation, to whom he left a stable and prosperous Pototan, may we take good care of it. May the legend of the mayor with the twin snake and his mango tree live forever. And may the legacy of the great Quedó Parcon be remembered for all eternity. So now, we have a new mayor in the person of Mayor Adi Lazaro, who is the nephew of Quedó Parcon, the son of his sister. And together with our municipal officials and together with us, the citizens of Pototan, let us all take Quedó as our guiding light as we march forward for the betterment of Pototan, especially now that we are facing the crisis of COVID-19, together with the guiding light of Quedó Parcon, we move forward and take this municipality to greater heights, even as we move forward into recovery from this crisis. Long live Quedó Parcon, mabuhay si Quedó, and thank you very much, Tito Kid, up there who is watching us now. Thank you for all the developments you brought Pototan, and thank you, Quedó Parcon, for all of what Pototan is today. Thank you very much, and we hope that you enjoy the rest of the day. And don't forget to remember Quedó Parcon in your prayers, because he was the one who made Pototan into this great municipality that it is now. So Salibat, this is former SB member Paolo Guanco, wishing you all a very good day. Thank you very much.